वेलकम जी। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस वन ऑफ द बेसिक कोर जावा स्ट्रक्चर, हाउ वी कैन क्रिएट पोजो, हाउ वी कैन क्रिएट जावा बींस, हाउ वी कैन क्रिएट यू कैन से एनी ऑब्जेक्ट विच होल्ड डेटा। फॉर जनरली इन जावा वी ऑलवेज क्रिएट अ पोजो प्लेन पोजो प्लेन ओल्ड जावा ऑब्जेक्ट, तो इस तरह प्लेन ओल्ड जावा ऑब्जेक्ट प्लेन ओल्ड जावा ऑब्जेक्ट। तो वी लर्न कि हाउ टू राइट पोजो, ईच एंड एवरी जावा डेवलपर नो it, but here I would like to add what Java as a going to change the way writing the these classes. Whenever we are writing the any Pojo, any Java bean classes, we have to write some extra setup code that is generally needed by the our JVM to know the particular class object how work. Now whenever Java are going to evolving ourselves, so in JDK 14 they introduced the concept how you write new way, different way your Pojo classes. Okay, so from first I am here explaining how we are writing initially Pojo classes, Java classes, Java bean classes, and now from JDK 40 onward, what are the different way we are writing those classes. Okay, let's see. If you want to write any class person, the basic sentence class person. Okay, and we have to curly braces start. Let's see, I am two field, name and age. So we have right here private string name, then we have right private int age. Okay, this is the basic, but one person have a name and age, this is the basic requirement. But for doing complete this is a person class, we have to, as per the Java guidelines, we have to write constructor, we have to write setter method, we have to write getter method, we have to override equal method, hash code method, true string method. Whenever we write all these steps, after that you can see our class is one Pojo created. Okay, let's I am writing here, I am writing your constructor. Okay, one constructor. Okay, two attributes need one constructor. Okay, or maybe you need default sometime default constructor, public person. Any class, this is the default constructor, this is the one argument constructor. The first we have to write constructor, then we have to write setter and getter method. Okay, setter and getter methods, these are setter and getter method. After that we have to write equal method, hash code method. Equal and hash code method. Now these are the equal method and these are the hash code method. Similarly, we have to write override two string method. So Now your POJO is completed. So for writing one Java class, we have to write this kind of class. Now we can say our Java person class is completed. Okay. So how to use in this POJO? In simply make a person or one object. Object one equal to new person, and now we have to set a person p1, we have to set p1 dot set name. We have set name bj. We have to set p1 dot set age, then we have to age 30. And you want to display the output, check output person dot p1 dot name plus p1 dot get age. So in this way, generally, in general, we are writing any POJO in Java. Okay, so we have to, as per our objective, there is one person class. They have two attributes, one with the name, one with the age. So for that, check. Okay, these are the objectives printed. Great. So you here will look the code. First, we have write these attributes, the constructor, then argument constructor. Then we have to write setter getter method. Setter getter method, then again we have to write your request method, your hashword method, then again we have to write your toString method. So this line of code we have to write to complete our POJO. So so Java have come with the purpose of this POJO is hold your object. Means Java now comes with a new concept of why we are not writing the concise way, simple way. What are the use? We have to create one object that have a two entity, two attributes, name and age, sufficient. Rest is a method, get method, set method, equals method, hashcode method, depend upon the uses. So these are the, these methods are flat. Always you write the same way. How to write constructor the same way. How to write getter method the same way. Each and every developer write the same way. Similarly, for those, your ID, IntelliJ ID, Eclipse, HTS, they provide to generate code. Their code is generated. Code is generated. Equal code is method generated. You can use. But what are the problem? Problem is that let's in future we have added some column. In that column, maybe you added one attribute. In that attribute, you have missed to add a constructor. You have missed to include your equals method. Maybe you missed to equal your hashcode method, can include all the attributes. In this way, we have option to miss the something. So, in Java 14, they introduced the new concept of writing your data. Data class or case class, you can say, that is known as a record class. Means now each and every object just like one record. So Java comes with a new concept of you are writing record classes. Let's see same person I want to write in a record class. So what are the syntax and semantics? For that, let's here is the they give a record keywords and give your person class, let's say people. Let's say person new class created. Now here come as a parenthesis and your curly braces. Now this is the record class is created. But this record class, we have to identify two attributes. So here I have to define a string name, and here I have to define int age. Now this code is sufficient for equivalent to your this line of code, almost your 50 line of codes. Now our compiler is so intelligent and they can create for you getter method, setter method, create for you your request method, hash code method, toString method, each and everything is placed here. How you can use it? Let's see. Comment out. Okay, simply we have used the bar person one object one equal to new person new, and we have to pass your name, then and age 45. Now this object is created and you can just print object one and you are able to check your object is printed. So this is the very concise way of writing now POJO classes in Java. Different than other languages, Kotlin as a language, Scala as a language, C as a language, they have already this kind of classes, how you write a class in small way, concise way. In Kotlin, known as a data classes, in Scala, known as a case classes, I think. And similarly, in the case of C has known as a record. So similarly, Java come, you can define your classes. So here, means now we are not defining as a class in sort as per my, we are defining only constructor. We are defining only constructor. That means these variables, whenever sometime you want to know ki what are the, I want to know the name or age. For that we have a method name, you are getting a method. You want to age, we have a method age. These are the sufficient available for you. They provide you as a method. So here you can also get equal method, hash code method, to string, any method you want to here invoke. You want to invoke hash code, you invoke hash code. You want to invoke toString, each method is available for you. Okay. Okay, now you have hash code. Similarly, you want to toString, you have written a toString, the method override for you. That means ki this new concept of writing class in the form of record, now this is some kind of special class known as a data carrier class. This class is responsible to holding a data. That data is by default, these fields are final. And this record class is the final as well as. You cannot extend, you cannot modify anyway. Once you have created this record, these are the you can use. But sometime I want to check, let's keep particular employee can have age like minus 5. In this case, your system throw, system, I think logically system doesn't allow a person have a negative number. So here, how can apply in the case of old Java classes, we have a setter method, go in setter method here, go in setter method and age, and here apply your condition. If age less than 0, then throw null pointers. Throw new runtime exception. Negative or not allowed. Hello? Not allowed. similar kind of thing you can write in full classes. So this is also you can write in case classes. For case classes, you have to write here the comp. This is your primary constructor. Okay. Now have a compact constructor. Just you like public, person, and curly braces star. This is the compact constructor. Here you can say if age less than 0, throw runtime exception. Negative value as age not allowed. When you run it, now you have pass a minus 2. If you are going to run it, the system API throw exception, negative value as is not allowed. In this case, what kind of validations you want the particular field, you can apply here. Okay. So first things here, whatever you need kind of validation you can also use. Sometimes I want to write some methods, some static data member, all and everything you can write here as your needed. If you want to declare some static variable, you can declare a static variable as well as integer x. Okay, you can write some static method, you can write a static method, static just void do test, and you can perform any returns like return any value returns. Let's see, I mean return some integer value, integer, so return here integer, let's see x plus plus, whichever you want to write here at needed. You can write any generic from public function which can be accessible as a your string get name with x value. You can write here return name plus some x value which you want. Any kind of for variable you can say method, variable, count, here you can write. Okay, and you can similarly if you need you can access here as well as. Okay, here you can access. So in short, Java come with a new way of writing code. Your code come so concise. What needed you have to write here. First, your record is a one new keyword. This is your class name, or this is your primary constructor. Which attribute you want here? Now your record class is completed, and you can just use new keyword and apply your constructor value. By default, these fields are now Java go. In the directions where you are writing your classes and attribute as finals and immutables. Now in this case, record is helping to write code in immutable format. Now this class is immutable. Generally, our existing old Pojo classes are by default means inherently in nature in the form of mutation. The set age, set name, set value means by nature we are mutating the value. Now Java shift from mutation object to the immutable object. Now record class is by default immutable class. Which value you are going to put here, that is immutable. This value you cannot modify. You can access here, but you cannot modify it. You can apply some validation here. You can apply some validation here, you cannot modify your. These are the by default immutable. And this class by default is the final class. You cannot inherit, you cannot do something else. So once you created one, so this is the record class is one kind of special. You can say data carrier class, which is responsible to holding data and transferring from one method to another method, one JVM to another one, anywhere you can transfer one thread to another thread. But in the case of multi-threading, if your record, if your object is immutable, be frankly, you pass this message to multiple threads. Each thread can access, each thread cannot modify this value. And now your application would work like a thread save. So that this way, they are Java are evolving rapidly. So my input is when I read JDK 14 feature enhancement. Now you have no currently this record feature in Java 14 as a preview feature. Now you can, whenever you are going to the need to compile your Java code, you have to use the enable preview feature. Then you are able to compile the code and run the code. Means Java comes with the new features and new concept with the first is a preview feature. Initially, developer can go and use and fill some feedback, give feedback accordingly. Java can again modify it. If one version, two version, check preview feature is good, as developer can adopting. Now maybe in coming releases, this record feature, this record classes will become a standard feature. I'm sure this would be become a standard feature because this record class are remove lots of boilerplate code. This is a lots of boilerplate code which we don't want to write in generally. Okay, always whenever ask someone to write the code, any developer does not write to this code. They ask editor ID generate this code. So unnecessary code, whenever I always say, whenever you are writing code, you are writing code once, but you are reading multiple times. So always, whenever any developer come and look your code, they are going to go and read these classes, unnecessary. Why did our, just from Pojo, from our Java being object, I want to communicate data from one place to another place. In that case, record classes is helpful. So you use and syntax semantic wise, it's very not heavy. Simple syntax, you anyone can use it. Simple record keyword and write your data a class which you want, and after that which attributes they contain. Means in generally before this record classes, we are generally writing a class. But now we are writing a constructor as a primary constructor. So this is known as your primary. This is known as your primary constructor. Okay, and this is your known as a compact constructor. This constructor doesn't take any argument. Okay, this is your compact constructor. This is your compact constructor. This is your primary constructor. Now we are not going to write a class. Just we are going to write as a constructor. A constructor make a object file. Okay. One might you notice that here I am using the bar as a keyword. In from Java 11 onward, you can use as a bar as a local reference variable. So in case after before Java, if using that in the that case we have to use here your class name as well as, but from Java 11 onward we have option you can use a bar, and bar is the generic types. They can hold the compiler run type. Java is a static type language, and they are identify data type at the compile time. Okay, so compiler automatically identify which kind of variable you are assigning in the bar. Okay, so hope useful to you. And you try to use this record classes, and this is very, very I personally feel save lot of developer times to write a classes, and developer now feel confidence they can write a classes, mutable classes. Generally, for writing any classes, a immutable class, multiple set of statement developer have to write and ensure that my class is immutable. Now, just write record classes, by default record classes is immutable, and you can, this immutable class pass to any multi-thread environment and your application behavior is consistent. Okay, so this is very helpful. This is I also going to use currently, and also recommend you will try to use it, and they are very concise. Multiple benefit, you have write less code, you have write you have avoid unnecessary violated code, you have to by default get immutability, by default thread safety, and less writing. Thank you. Hope it's useful for you. If you have any query, comment, please write in comment. I will reply. Thank you.